Did you know it's estimated that the average person makes over 35,000 API calls per day from mobile apps to web platforms? Twitter API handles over 13 billion daily requests, while Google Maps API processes around 2 trillion requests annually. The global API market reached over $6 billion in 2023. Now, this highlights the ubiquity of APIs in our daily digital lives. However, according to Gartner, in 2022, API leaks and hacks were the most frequent attack vector, resulting in data breaches for enterprises' web applications. So as developers, we all have been there, right? Building or connecting APIs. And a common pain point problem for developers is finding consistent, secure, fast, and error-prone way to connect APIs. With Appsmith and Strapi, you can easily connect your backend and frontend, saving developers like you and me time and effort. By leveraging the seamless integration between these two platforms, you can focus on building the user experience and business logic rather than worrying the underlying API integration. So today, you will learn how to connect Strapi and Appsmith using the REST API layer so you can quickly and securely build Appsmith applications that query your Strapi content immediately. Let's get started. All right, here we are in Strapi, which I am self-hosting in Google Cloud Platform. In case you want to do the same, there is a link in the description with the full tutorial on how you can self-host Strapi in Google Cloud Platform and follow along. Now, for this example that I'm going to be building, I have a event content type in Strapi, and the idea is that we're going to be building a event management system in Appsmith to showcase the integration between these two platforms. So go to the settings on Strapi, and right now I'm running 4.20.1 version, but this should work for most of the Strapi versions out there. Now go to the API tokens section, and here we will create a new API token to securely connect Appsmith and Strapi. So let's create a new one. This one I'm going to call Appsmith, or whatever name you want to give it, a description. And then you have the token duration. I'm just going to set it to 7 days right now, but depending on your configuration and environment, you want to set another value. From my personal standpoint, an unlimited token duration is not a good practice from a, you know, security standpoint. And then the token type, you have read-only to only be able to read data, but don't write any data to Strapi, full access, which again, I wouldn't recommend, or custom, which is normally the way I go. So let's select custom. And for this one, again, I just want to be able to read and write events front and back and forth Strapi. So I'm going to find one, create, update, and delete. But again, you can fine grain which actions this API token will be able to execute. And for everything else, I'm not going to give any permissions needed for the content type builder, email, upload, etc. So let's save it. And we have to copy and make sure to store it in a secure place because we won't be able to retrieve back this token again. So let me just put it around here so we can use it later on. All right, and let's save it. And that's it for the Strapi side. Now let's go to the Appsmith side. And here I have an empty application, which I'm going to be using to, you know, go through the integration. So the first thing we want to do is create a new data source. So go to the data section here on the left and select your first data source, in my case. And you will find in the API section something called Authenticated API. Let's select that one. And now let's give it a name. I'm going to call it Strapi. And now let's put the URL. The URL will be the domain of your Strapi instance, /API. So that's normally how Strapi handles the API. And you can manage your own headers and your own query parameters, but the only thing that is really important in this case is the authentication, which we're going to be using the barrier token. So let's select barrier token and paste the token that we saved it a couple of seconds ago. There you go. And now let's save it. And that's it. Now we have a authenticated API, which Appsmith is going to be handling the token, inserting the token into all of the requests and managing and making sure that everything is securely authenticated. So let's go to the editor section and let's create a new query based upon the data source we just created. So let's select Strapi data source. And now, as you can see, Appsmith is going to pre-fill some of the values in here. Now, this looks very similar to Postman or most of the API tools out there, so it should be very familiar to you. So now all we have to do is just fill the data that we need in order to make our request. I'm gonna call it get events, and it's gonna be a get type of request. And now all we have to do is put the portion that we care, which is events. So that's the name of the get method to the content type that we built, which is events. All right. And now we don't have to put any type of header authentication or anything like that, because again, Appsmith is going to be handling that. So if we run it, we should be able to actually get a response. And that's true. If we can see now we have our data array, which is normally the way that Strapi returns the data. And then for each element inside, for each object inside the data array, we normally have all the values of the fields as the attributes. That's normally the way to go with Strapi. And here it is. We can see all the information about the events we had in the Strapi site. If we go to the content manager, we'll see, yeah, we have two events. One is reusability in Appsmith and using Appsmith AI classification. And that's the same thing we are looking at here in the site of Appsmith. So now we can actually start building our UI against this API. For this example, I'm just going to be building a list because I want to be able to view the events from Strapi. So the first thing we're going to do is drag and drop the list, and now delete this and bind the data. So remember, we gave it the name get events. That's what we're going to do. Then normally Appsmith stored the data of a response of a query in the data object. So we're going to select data. Now, remember that Strapi returns an array called data. So that's what we're going to be using. I know it looks weird to do data.data, but that's because Strapi sends the data called data and Appsmith stores on an object called data. So that's why it kind of look weird, but that's the way it is with this data structure that we have here. And as you can see, automatically Appsmith will understand that we have two objects inside the data array, and we can actually see the information of the attributes of each of the values here. So now let's actually bind the data fields into the widgets inside the list. So we don't actually have any image field for this specific list of the events. So we're going to be using these two fields that normally Appsmith put on a list. And this one we're going to be using for the title of the event. So I'm going to do current item that attributes, because remember that Strapi stores everything inside the object as attributes, and then the name of the field, which in this case is title. And now we're being able to see the title of the event. Let's change the title style and just make it larger. Let's say it's going to be an L size. And now let's actually reuse this field here. And we can do, again, current item.attributes and other field. In this case, I'm going to call it category. I'm going to find the category of this session or this event, and I'm going to make it smaller. Actually, we can even do a value, hard-coded value here, 0.4. That's too small, 0.5. There you go. And we can start doing the same with other fields in the array of data. Let's bring a new text widget here and showcase the date of this event. So again, current item that attributes that date. And there you go, we can see the date of the event. Now this date is kind of hard to read, you know, it's a formatted in UTC. So in case we want to format the date, we can do that here. So we can actually do, remember that Appsmith normally has the moment library, and you can see that by going to the libraries here on the left section, you will find the moment information here. So you can do moment past the date, and then we can do that format and pass the format that we want to send. So we can actually do something like this. And now that date is actually readable, human readable. And as we can see, this event is going to happen April the 4th, 2024, 1:30 p.m. Now, if you want to arrange or sort the data depending on this date, you can do that directly on your query. But that's directly a functionality in the REST API of Strapi and not in Appsmith itself. Or you could build a JavaScript object that pulls the data from the API and arrange the object data based upon the date field. There are multiple ways to do that. You can do that at the Strapi level or inside Appsmith, but there's multiple ways you can do that. And that's it. We can continue to do the same. You know, bring widgets into our list, arrange them in the way we want, and bind data from Strapi into Appsmith. So now if we deploy our app, we will be able to see data coming from Strapi into our management API system into Strapi. Now, in case you want to do something more advanced, like actually sending back data to Strapi, you can easily do that. Again, all you have to do is create your queries using the baseline we created as an authenticated database, and you can create your post, update, and any of the other methods that we support in HTTP. So that's it. That's how easy you can integrate Strapi and Appsmith using the REST API layer.